Aloha, everyone, and welcome to Ma'ali'e Sundays. We're here live once again from beautiful Kawaiwai in Kamo'ili'ili on Oahu. And so we'd like to welcome you joining from all over the world. We know we have our friends joining us on KSG Films Facebook, as well as the Shanalehua Facebook. Many of our friends that are cross-posting. But welcome to Ma'ali'e Sundays. My name is Sean. And we're super, super excited today to have some friends that I've worked with for many, many years. And we've got a chance to tour all over the world and make a bunch of records and write some new songs and all kinds of stuff. So before we get started, I want to thank KSG Films, Kili'i Grace, our director, for being here. Also on sound today, we have Jason Taglianetti from HPR, Music in a Small Room, and also Lona Nevalu assisting on audio. So thanks to them. Mahalo to, for them helping us out here at Kawaiwai and the staff here at Kawaiwai. Mahalo, mahalo. But we're going to get right into the music, and we're going to introduce our really, really good friends. We're super happy to have them today. The lovely Angela, Nalani, and Lehua, Naleo Pili Mihana.
Thanks, guys.
Here we go.
For Ma'ali'e Sunday, well, except for Pono, of course, obviously. But
and you hated it. You hated it.
Of course, I loved it. But it's nice to have the girls. Thanks, girls, for coming.
Oh, you're welcome.
It's different, right, when we're playing like this because there's nobody clapping. It's kind of like our old gigs at Chuck's Steakhouse. When nobody was clapping.
Or the family parties that everybody's all KKR, really, so they don't care. We're just playing to, you know, the wind. It's all good.
But yeah, so yeah, it's nice to be able to sing because it's been a while for us too. Our Mother's Day concerts, of course, got canceled and some other gigs that we had along the way. So thanks for coming. It's fun.
Yeah,
always fun to sing with you guys.
For inviting us to your second living room.
I know, right? I wish. And I need more to grasp this one. But I thought we'd take it back to the origins of our songs and our singing together. And do this song that we used to do together in concert glee at Kamehameha. Back in the 80s, I was in kindergarten, and you guys were, no, just kidding. We learned this one in concert glee, And we're going to feature the lovely Pono to dance his song for us, originally written and recorded by Andy Cummings.
There's a feeling deep in my heart, stabbing at me just like a dart. It's a feeling heavenly.
I see memories out of the past, memories that always will last, of a place beside the sea.
What year did you guys learn that song?
That was like 82, maybe, our junior year in Concert Glee.
Yeah. You guys did it for Concert Glee.
Yeah. Kahau Nani Aki was, she had the solo part.
Oh my gosh.
I remember
right.
her name. I just remembered it. And then, but I think Robert actually did the arrangement for that, right?
Like Robert
Kesmer. So we learned it. Yeah. Nice. And so we learned it as a choir. But yeah.
That's beautiful. Very, very beautiful. Thank you for doing that one.
That one.
I like the old stuff that you guys do because you guys started as a trio.
Yeah.
And then you added like the 27-piece band after. So, which was awesome for us because then we get to go with you guys. But when you guys started, like you played bass. You didn't play guitar.
And I played bass.
Yeah.
Guitar.
I played guitar because nobody wanted to lug it around.
Yeah, true. Yeah. Well, and then I had to lug the bass. What are you saying? That was kind of a lug.
Okay. Yeah, I guess so.
And you guys were the combo for...
Yes.
Yeah, for Concert Glee. Yeah. I mean, because the combo was always, you know, testosterone driven. Always. Because the hula dancers were all, you know, girls most of the time. And we just started playing our instruments and we wanted to do it. And, and you know, they kind of said, no, go away. And we said, and so, you know.
Yeah.
Nalani and Lehua hid their instruments, and then we got up, and then we just became the combo.
It was funny though because in the beginning there we were the combo, but we also had two other boys play with us. Harrison Murray, who's our classmate.
Oh yeah, Harrison.
Auntie Pat's son, yeah. And then and then this other boy, David Huihui, who was younger than us.
Okay, yeah.
But we used to like accidentally leave his guitar.
No, let's reiterate the word we.
No, Lenny used
not,
to.
Not we, no we.
I'm just kidding. No, and then, you know, eventually we kind of muscled them out and then we became a combo. That's how you do it, girls. Okay.
Well, that's a made-up story right there.
No, it is not. Huh?
Well, I like the arrangements you guys come up with because, you know, like a lot of the stuff was originally just like a three-piece sort of trio thing. And then you guys just kind of like the next song, like the Nat King Cole medley. Mm-hmm. It's like something that you guys would just sit around and jam. And I think that's what everybody fell in love with. Yeah. So
I think so.
Yeah. Well, and I think the interesting part about us when we started is... We never, like, someone doesn't always sing the melody in a song.
Mm-mm.
Normally, one person will sing the melody through the whole song.
Mm.
But we've got a couple of numbers way when we first started that we would jump all over the place.
Right, right.
You know, like Beauty Hula, we jumped all over that song. Mm. And and so we can never sing it solo because,
yeah.
you know, I'll be singing two lines of melody, then I jump into the low harmony, and then I jump someplace else.
Yeah. Or you can't kick anybody out of the group.
No, yeah. Job security.
Yeah, job security.
They did that, yeah. Let's do the next one, Nat King Cole medley.
Yeah, so we're big fans of Nat King Cole, and we just kind of put three of his songs together, and we called it the Nat King Cole medley.
Yeah, why don't you start this one, Alan?
Okay.
Yeah.
It winds from Chicago to LA, more than 2,000 miles all the way. Get your kicks on Route 66.
Well, you go through St. Louis and Joplin, Missouri, and Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty. You'll see Amarillo and Gallup, New Mexico. Well, Flagstaff, Arizona, and don't forget Winona, Kingman, Boston, San Bernardino.
Only you get hip to this timely tip. When you make that California trip, get your kicks on Route 66.
Some love, Aaron. Yeah, Hilo boys, go.
Well, you go through St. Louis and Joplin, Missouri, and Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty. You'll see. For the way you look, you're looking at me, yeah. Everything was on the square. The buzzard tried to throw the monkey off his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. But cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of jiving? Straighten up. Blow your top." The buzzard told the monkey, "You are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free." The monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye and said, "Your story's so touching, but it sounds like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of jiving? You better straighten up and fly right. But cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top."
Yeah. Fun, fun, fun. Yeah, that's the old jams right there.
That's some jams.
Listen, can you just sit around and drink and... and strum, huh?
Drink water.
So speaking of which, you know, we were talking about how long you guys have been together. How many years has it been? Mm-hmm. Not to put you on the spot, but you can count from high school or you can
38.
Count 38 years.
Oh, that we were singing as
a
group?
Yeah, 38.
Yeah,
38.
Yeah, there's years. Many ways to count that.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah.
We got together officially as Naleo when we were the combo, I would guess, right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So that was
1982.
That was like the official, the official.
Yeah, I feel like that was the
that's
official.
That's when we did Stray Cat Strut, so that was 82.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one, too.
Goodness.
Yeah. And then what year was it that you guys won Brown Bags?
84.
That was your senior
year. The
best
year.
The best year. Don't make me bring up song contests. Like,
that was clearly not our fault. I'm just going to say.
So anyway, going back, we want to, I know there's so many things that everybody wants to know about you guys, and you can go on the Facebook if there's something that you guys want to know, like you can, you know, comment on the KSG Films Facebook or the Shana Lehua Facebook, and we have somebody, Pono, a producer, that's looking through the comments if there's something like a fun fact that you might want to ask or something like that. But we're going to take it back a little bit, and I'm actually going to put you guys on the spot one by one, and I'm going to start with Angie.
The dating
and
game.
Ask her, like, what is, like, probably, let's see, like, one of the most fun trips, let's go with that. What's the most fun, like, tour that you've been on with the group and why? Or something memorable, something memorable.
Well, it's got to be a tour that you've been on.
No, it doesn't have to be. But we did have some good times.
We had some good times. Okay, so let's reword that question.
Okay.
One of the worst tours that we had happened to be, parts of that tour happened to be the most fun, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
Because it was just a really poorly produced and promoted tour. And we
not our fault.
Well, not our fault. And we affectionately called it the suck tour. But we had some amazing people on that tour with us. You know, and and it was fun.
That was early in our career.
Very early.
We made it fun.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And the one of the fun parts is that we actually were, all of us, after a show, we were starving and nothing's open.
Right.
And we're walking the streets of Seattle or something.
Tacoma, okay, which is Tacoma. Really yeah. bad because yeah. it was and we were a out sketchy in the neighborhood.
Right, middle of nowhere, and, yeah. and everything is closed. Nothing's there. And so we keep walking, but we see it at the top of this building. There's lights going on, like there's some disco happening. So we go up there thinking maybe they might have food. They had no food.
At the disco?
At the disco. They had no food, but we danced like crazy that night.
And it was the 90s, so it was literally a
yeah,
disco.
And Tony Silva was with us, so of course, you know, mechanical masters all yeah. over the yeah. place. But it was just, parts of it was super fun, uh-huh. you know, but we affectionately called it the suck
the
tour.
The suck tour.
The suck tour, yeah.
I'm not going to ask you why else it sucked, but yeah. So what did you learn from that tour so that you make sure that that doesn't happen again?
We changed promoters and producers and stuff like that.
And managers.
Okay. Yeah.
And managers.
We changed everything.
We changed everything except each other.
Yeah.
That's the constant right yeah. here. Yeah. 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 Well, I know we were talking about how many albums you guys have done too as well. Do you remember?
I don't know. Nalani usually has all of them, so I don't know.
Because counting like
24.
24.
I think.
And then the last one was released last year.
Beautiful Day was
yeah, the year
beautiful.
Before, 2018.
Oh, yeah, because it won the, yeah, it won the 2019, it won the Hoku for that. That's right. I know this year's going by so fast, like I'm losing count of how many years it's been since we've been locked down.
Yeah. Sometimes I really don't know what day it is.
Yeah.
You got to look at the calendar.
It's just day.
It's just a day.
Well, we're going to do the next song, which is off of the Beautiful Day album. And actually, Nalani wrote the title track for that album, which is a fun song to play, Beautiful Day. But this is a song that you guys did with Jake, right?
Yeah, so, you know, when we were collectively deciding what songs were going to be on this album, this one song, it's a cover, it really resonated with me. Plus, too, the world we live in right now, and all the different things that are going on, the chaos in the world, you know, everything. And at the time that we did this album, there was a lot of things happening anyway, and I thought, you know, the one constant that we try to share with people is love.
Right.
It's always about love.
Right.
So we asked Jake. We thought it'd be really nice to just have it very simple. Mm-hmm. And so Jake was very gracious, and we were very honored to have him come on and do
that. It's so funny because you can just say Jake, and everybody knows what Jake it is.
Yeah. Right.
You know, he's like Cher or Madonna. There's only one Jake.
Right.
You gotta go like this, Jake.
Well, why don't we do this one? It's a old Beatles tune, which is.
Oh, I wanted to just say, Sean, look, Pat said, looking and sounding great, Angie.
Pat.
Pimentel.
Oh, who's that? Cute. No, that's my stepmom. Thank you. Just kidding.
Dad.
Thank you, Pat.
Lickens.
I know, my dad's still going to give me lickens. Yeah. But Pat made, who made your guys' lepo'o?
And Sato. Thank you for our lepo'o, Ann. Yes. And thank you to Denise for our beautiful Poikini
Kenyas. Oh, beautiful.
But Pat made Pono's lei, right?
Pat made Pono's.
It's pretty, too.
She spoils her. Every week she gets new lei.
I know,
so.
Right?
Anyway, let's do this song. It's a beautiful old Beatles tune. And it's exactly.
Did the Beatles do this?
No.
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 It's everyone but the Beatles did this.
Everyone but the Beatles did this.
That's
one.
What you meant.
Yeah.
If anybody knows who was the original singer of this, go on and, you know, send us a message and we'll give you a round of applause. How's that?
I like this. But it's exactly what the world needs. So.
That's true.
Yeah.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb. There are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not
just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow. There are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to shine. Oh, listen, Lord, if you wanna know. Yes, we know what the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for love, sweet love. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. What the world needs now is love, sweet love.
Yeah.
And a little chicken katsu too.
And a little applause.
Yeah.
All right.
Lots of people responded.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So what is the answer?
What's the answer?
Well, they didn't give us the answer. They just...
They responded.
Oh.
Okay.
What's her name, right? Did it?
What's her face?
There's a bunch of people that did it, but...
Dionne Warwick.
Dionne Warwick.
Oh, yeah, Dionne Warwick. That's right. That's right.
One of the most...
I think the biggest hit, but there was somebody before her, too, that recorded it.
Yeah. Mm. Aaron, do you know?
A guy. Oh.
There was a guy who did it.
See, too bad Rod wasn't here. Rod knows all these things. These useless
Jackie, Jackie DeShannon.
Jackie
Burt
Bacharach
wrote it.
Oh, Burt Bacharach
wrote it.
Of course he wrote it.
Yeah.
He writes all the good stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Dionne Warwick's version was like the popular
the
one that everybody remembers.
Yeah, right.
And now she's on the Psychic Network, so. Yeah.
But we knew that was coming. Yeah. Right?
Well, she knew.
She
we didn't
knew.
Know. She knew. Right? But you can know, too, if you call. Right?
Okay, I do have a little trivia, though.
Yeah.
Yes. Is, yeah, we used to play trivia at some of our gigs.
All the time.
You remember that? We'd play with the audience and it was fun. But I was just sitting here thinking that if we've been playing together for 38 years, let's say, this is the first time that Naleo has done what?
Oh. I don't know.
I know. I thought of all
for the whole set.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Oh, yeah, okay, I got it now. I had like a whole bunch of inappropriate stuff going through my head first.
Well, clean it up.
Oh, you mean besides the CBD stuff that we did?
No, just kidding.
The real Naleo fans might know this.
Yeah,
I know, it was kind of strange when we
Naomi Tanaka
started.
I expect she might know.
Yeah, you can comment on that too and see who gets the answer. I think everyone's going to miss that one.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
There's actually... that, and then there's another first time.
There is?
Today, yes.
Oh,
there's another first time today.
Oh, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I'm guessing too.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking too.
Oh, okay. I got it.
Okay, anyway, the audience is like, what?
Thanks, Tracy. Well, this next song is one of our favorites. I know it's a crowd favorite as well. And Nalani wrote this song. Years ago.
She did, indeed.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, okay.
You want to tell us about
it? I think
I
might know what song
I always do this to Lehu. I'm like, you know that song that you guys did with Naleo?
Like,
she's like,
you got to give me a little bit more than that.
571, but it's about your hometown. And
Yeah. So as you can tell by my dark, luscious tan, I was born and raised on the North Shore.
They actually used her
Oahu.
To white balance the cameras today. just
oh, I can think of some choice... comebacks.
You see how when we go back to the beginning when I said we, let's reiterate the we.
Anyway, go ahead with your story, Nalani, please.
Thanks, Lehua. But born and raised on the North Shore, I went to Kamehameha since kindergarten, and so we would travel down from Waihewa, coming down the winding road as you're heading home after school, and you could see the ocean start to open up in front of you. Now, this was before, because you'll hear in the song, I talk about the sugar cane. Nowadays, there's no sugar cane anymore. There used to be lots of pineapple. There's still a little bit pineapple. But there was a section where the pineapple ended and the sugarcane began, and that's right where the surf would start to open up in front of you. And I remember my two brothers were surfers, and they'd check the surf, and they'd be like, oh, yeah, surf looks good from here. You know, you can tell because you can see the white caps, but it's also really clean. Anyway, North Shore is a beautiful place to grow up, and one day older, I was maybe in my mid-20s, and you know, that childhood memory comes back. I'm driving home and just had a really hard day at work, and I was stressed out, and I realized that was one of the things that always kind of brought me back to center, was coming down that road and being able to just relax and see the ocean. So,
nice.
North Shore Serenade.
Yeah, one of our favorites. Original song written by Nalani. Mahalo for that. Yeah. Well, we're going to get a little serious right now, as if we haven't been serious. But, you know, we've been going through some crazy times right now in the world, and there's so much loss. And it's a very heavy time for many, many people. And especially, gosh, in the last few weeks, we've lost so many friends, here in the music business, Uncle Willie K, Brother Kolana Pakele as well, who you know, we still miss dearly. But just recently, we've lost a few other people that maybe we didn't know personally, but indirectly we were almost like, you know, we almost like spent time with them, you know. Mm-hmm. And one of them being the Kalamas.
Ka'ohi.
Kalamas, yeah. I mean, Ka'ohi Kalama, I'm sorry. But Kekolike Kalama, who was a policeman that was killed in duty only like 4 months ago, wasn't very long ago, his wife passed away. Mm-hmm. And it's just such a heavy time for their family. We can't imagine what they're going through, especially their son Mana, who I believe is at Kamehameha as well.
Yeah, I think so.
And so we'd like to send out a special song to their ohana, as well as Te Ruko Dorothy Avakuni.
Avakuni, yes.
Yes, yes, yes. So I think at this time, you know, if you want, we want to send this one out to all those people that were very, very dear to us, and maybe they didn't pass away like just recently. But you know, if you want to go on and Facebook and dedicate this song to them, you know, you can put in the comments who this is for, and let them know, because that's how we celebrate people's lives, especially after they pass away, is to, you know, celebrate their names. That's how us Hawaiians do it. You know, we write mele about their names, we celebrate their inoa, and that will always live on with us. And so this is a very special song that Lehua wrote. I'm sure that you guys have all known, but we've never talked about the story behind the song, or what really kind of you know, pushed you to do this, or inspired you to write this song.
Yeah. Well, it's actually, it's sort of innocuous. I mean, I'd gone to see a movie. I was living in Hilo at the time, and I saw the movie Philadelphia.
Oh yeah, that was with Tom Hanks.
Tom Hanks, yeah. And then, I don't know, there's just something about it that struck me. I went home, I grabbed my guitar, and I was just sitting there, and I thought about love in all of its forms, you know, and how, you know, love is just love. I mean, you can't really say that somebody can love someone and someone can't, and, you know, it's not something that you can assign to a certain group of people or anything, you know. Love is love, and so I just wrote this song, and I was thinking about that, and when someone that you love, you know, is going through something, that you just want to be there for them.
Right.
And a little side note, because I remember playing this song, and we all got together at Nalani's house up in Haleiwa at the time, and Jack had come.
Mm-hmm.
But we were there, and we were playing guitar, playing music in her garage. All her neighbors were like looking over the fence and joining us, was cruising. We went to the beach, went swimming. Mm-hmm. It was just a fun like overnighter. And I'd actually called Jack, and I said, oh, you know, I'm working on a bridge. I'm trying to figure out how to, you know, modulate or whatever. And then he's actually the one that came up with the modulation part of this
what?
Song. Over the phone, he sent it to me. And I said, that's perfect, Jack. Thank you so much. So, Jack, thank you so much for all of your help over the years.
Yeah.
And Jack, you know how to use the phone? That was a little high tech.
It's coconut wireless back then.
You got a dial. Yeah. You got a dial.
Pager was pager back right. then.
And he wrote the Pearl City alma mater too.
And he
co-wrote that too.
Oh my goodness.
Jeez. Yeah. Well, thank you, Jack, for kukuing on this song. But we want to send this one out to the Avakuni Ohana, as well as the Kalama Ohana. We actually did this song a couple months ago when we started doing these lives, and we had a request from our friend Donard to send this one out to the Kalama Ohana, and Ko'ohi was on our Facebook.
She commented.
And yeah, and so she had commented and you know, thanked us for doing this song, and so it's so heartbreaking that this song is for her now.
You'll fly with angels.
Avakunis for the Columbus. Ooh, mahalo. That was a hard one to get through. But that's part of the healing process, right?
So, yep. You know, I wanna mention something. Ken Mukuokane was our producer on that song. And he did something really interesting in the bass line. So if you go back and listen to the original recording, you'll hear the bass line, instead of being a standard, like a quarter note or half note or whatever, it sounds like a heartbeat. And so it goes like dung, 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 dung. And there was a famous author, actually, his name was Paul Purcell, and he wrote a national bestseller, and he was on Oprah Winfrey talking about this song.
Oh, wow.
Because he used to vacation here.
Wow.
And he said that certain songs have healing properties, especially if it's a baby or someone who's grieving, but they can hear the heartbeat in the song. They get that sense of drawn to it, and
right.
So that's the
heavy
beauty of music.
Yeah. It emulates those things that we're drawn to. You know, us Hawaiians write songs about our environment. You hear the birds, the fish, the winds, the rains, all those things that are healing properties to us. And I think that's likened to like motherhood. You know, to hear that heartbeat and be drawn to that, and it's comforting and loving and stuff. So, but yeah, it's always heavy to do that one. But so we're gonna move on a little bit, and now we're gonna pass the torch on over to Nalani, and maybe lighten up the mood a little bit. Everybody's getting a little heavy over here, but and we no can drink, you know.
So, we ain't heavy.
Yeah. But maybe not. It doesn't have to be a trip or a tour or anything like that. But maybe I know what's something
stupid that Lehu has done in the past that you'd like me to tell everybody in the
world.
You
read my mind. That's exactly what I was going to ask. Yes.
Oh my gosh. How many can I count?
Yes. Can you mute Lehu's mic too, so she can't say that?
Why don't you ask her the easier question? What not stupid thing did Lehu do?
Actually, both of them. Like, what's something funny or, embarrassing or that maybe of the other two that maybe nobody knows, you know?
Yeah, well, I don't think there's anything.
I'm not talking to you, Lehu.
Well, we've had many, many adventures in different times of our life. Most that we cannot speak about because, that's the code. That's the girl code.
What?
But
this is the internet. You can talk about whatever you want.
But I will tell you something cool about Lehua, okay? It's only one thing cool about her, but I'll tell you this because this is a little known fact. So in school, we were all in the dorms together, from seventh grade, Lehu and I, and then Angie later in high school. But her mom was so fantastic. I was always jealous because her mom would sew her the most elaborate Halloween costumes ever.
Yeah.
I mean, like, amazing. Head to toe, zip up in them, you know, kind of like, and she had, in seventh grade, a bear suit. Okay, I was like so envious of her. Now
on purpose.
It was a brown bear suit, like made of like velour or
that
something.
That was like before those onesies were in too. You know?
Yeah, like yeah. She totally made it from scratch. And Lehua would like zip it up, and then of course she had really bushy hair back then, so it kind of like matched, right? It just all blended in. And
you never have to shave then. Right?
Hey, this is my story, Sean. No,
I was trying to help you.
It was only in seventh grade. We never have hair yet.
So she had this great costume. Then they would do like a border, you know, like contest for Halloween. And we're all like broke, right? And then we cannot go anywhere. So we have to just find any kind, like you're looking at like, what can I do with my cotton balls or something? You know, like try to find stuff you have in your room that you can make a costume out of. But Lehua had the bear suit. So every year she would win. So Auntie Pat, if you're listening to this story,
I'm sure she is.
Yes. Thank you for making Lehua fabulous, at least for one day of the year. Then she would decide to just wear it randomly. Like, you never know. Like, it could be like she'd pop out of the laundry room in the middle of the night with the bear suit on. You know, it became this running gag.
Well, why should it only be one day? That's Halloween funny. Should yeah. be every day.
Reuse.
Every day.
That's yeah. an awesome story. I never heard that one before.
Okay. And most of the world has not heard it.
Yeah, my mom made some fabulous stuff.
That's awesome.
Yeah, she did. She
okay, do sorry. Angie. Do Angie.
Yeah, do Angie. Do Angie. Wait. Wait, I get to do Angie
yes,
too?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
No. Yeah, I'm afraid. Because that means yeah. it's coming back around okay. like a boomerang.
And she went already.
No, yeah, she was first. That's why we make her go first.
You only got to worry about me.
Okay.
I'm next.
Okay, Angie. I remember in high school.
Have you noticed I've been working out. Like my muscles look really good.
Oh, intimidation.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go
can
ahead.
Can you
go
reach?
Ahead.
Can you reach here?
I can reach.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Angie in high school was like, like. Fabulous, right? So so I was like a little shy. Lehua was very nerdy. No, wait.
What?
I was not nerdy.
Very nerdy.
and Angie was like outgoing and she danced.
She was a popper.
She was a pop lock.
Lock. Yes.
Papa Lock. Mm-hmm. Not Papa Lock. That's a company. Okay. She it's wasn't a Papa Lock.
Yeah. She would break into cars.
And it wasn't Papa Smurf or anything, but she had the pop and lock. Yeah. Thing going with the suspenders.
Yeah, yeah,
the
like,
black
rerun,
pants.
Like rerun. Rerun.
Yeah, rerun. Pull the socks yeah. up
not
to the
knees. Not
as
big as rerun, though. But like,
no, she was skinny. She was skinny. And then her popping partner
yeah.
was Tira Auna.
Yeah.
Yes. And they had their routines that they would do. So, you know, once you're known for that, like yeah. every like yeah. dance or whatever, yeah. people like, yeah.
What was the name of you guys' gang or group or what? Troop?
Crew. I don't know if you had crew.
Crew. Had bits and pieces, that's why
yeah,
back then.
Yeah, bits and pieces yeah, was yeah, back yeah. then,
yeah.
too.
What you guys
oh, what? You're putting them down. You're going to pop for us.
Oh, freak out.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I don't know.
Oh. No, me and Tittle was just me and Tittle.
Yeah. They didn't really have a name. But they were really good. Yeah. They had the white gloves and everything.
Yeah. They were great.
Not the rubber gloves.
That came later.
Okay, so that's my memory.
Wow, that's
those
a good
are good,
one.
Melanie.
I like that one. Okay, all right.
Can't wait till my turn.
Oh, we can't give one of Nalani?
No. Power.
Why not? Why not? Why not?
Oh, no,
why
it's not? Nothing crazy. You know, why Nalani not? Had this one strip of like,
hair.
Like
acne?
almost like oh. she was going to color her hair, and they started the peroxide process, and then she didn't want to do it anymore. And she said, stop. She just had this one. Or was it two?
No, it was just one.
It was just one. Yeah. I thought that was kind of cool. I was like, hey,
it
look.
Was two.
Oh.
I did it in college. I was in the mainland. I did it in college.
It
yeah, it was two. And then you guys used to say it was like dog ears. Because it was like white.
Oh, no, you know what? I only see one side of your face. I never know.
That's why she saw one on That's this so side true. And one on the other side.
I was way ahead of my time. I look back and I say, wow.
Yeah,
are
we said
pictures?
We said wow.
Are there pictures? There gotta be
there
pictures.
There are pictures.
Yeah,
pictures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Polaroids.
You know, one of my favorite pictures of the three of us is I'm in the middle and I'm up high with Solomon.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the three of us.
And we have our hands on your tummy.
Yeah, that was
and we're wearing Betty Moos and we're playing music at Kimo Farms.
Yes. See how quick those things come up, those memories?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Famous photos.
Too long you guys been together, yeah. So.
A long time.
Well, here's one, a song that we always get requests for as well. And that Nalani sang the lead on this one. It's an old Phoebe Snow song. It's one of our favorites. Yeah.
Oh,
and
okay.
How'd you choose this one? How'd you choose this one too? Or was it recommended?
Yeah, it was
her voice,
recommended because they said she sounded like her.
Yeah, yeah.
And no, but that was after the fact.
No, right?
Yes, the comment of her sounding like Phoebe Snow was because they heard her sing Poetry Man.
Oh, I thought we picked it because they said she sounded like her.
You know, I'm a blank on that one. I can remember the bear suit and the pop-a-lock, but I don't remember
all
why we chose this
stuff.
Song.
You remember all the important stuff, the stuff of substance, right?
Well, maybe because she was singing the commercial all the time.
Yeah, the cotton one.
Yeah, the look, the feel of cotton.
Yeah.
The fabric of your life.
You guys sing like so many commercials. You guys do the U-Band commercial too?
She does. Angie did it. See? There were different ones. That's why.
What's
U-Band?
The other one? You guys. Yeah. You guys like come up with all these little excerpts from TV and stuff like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we did a dog food commercial once.
We did. We had to do a dog food commercial once. Yeah. But that was for Concert Glee.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, was it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Gosh. All right. Well, let's do this one. Okay. You want to start this one, Nalani?
You can start them for us, Sean.
Oh. I like it when you play the guitar.
I'll play the water bottle.
Man, you make things all right. Yeah, yeah.
do, yeah, yeah, yeah. Again, it's time to say so long and so recall the color of life. La 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 la, you're going home.
You're
now.
Going home.
Home's a place somewhere you go each day to see why.
See why.
Oh, talk to me some more, 'cause you don't have to go, 'cause you're the poetry man, you make things all right, yeah, yeah. Oh, talk to me some more, you know that you don't have to go, 'cause you're the poetry man, you make things all right.
Yeah, 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 yeah. We're going to write a song like that. It's just, yeah, 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 yeah. Right.
I got a text. I have to send a shaka out to Sunny from Kauai.
All right.
All right.
Sunny.
Sunny?
Everybody Kauai. On Kauai named Sunny going right on, bro.
That's me.
Before we go on, we want to introduce our friends that are joining us as well.
Yeah, how could we not?
Why don't you do that, Leo?
Okay, sure. On keyboards, we have Mr. Aaron Nelson. Yeah. He is from Hilo.
Yeah.
And a phenomenal musician. Besides yeah. keyboards, he can play electric guitar. Yeah. He's a whiz on the ukulele.
Yeah.
And he plays plays with his phone. Oh, plays with his wallet.
And his Kamen Riders.
Kamen Riders.
And his Kikaiders.
Yeah, Kamen Rider dolls. Yeah.
Why don't you tell a little fun story about Aaron?
Aaron? Oh, gosh. Yeah. What's
okay,
not
well,
to tell?
Well, oh, it's so easy to tell a story about Aaron. Aaron is the ramen expert.
Yeah.
Whenever we go to Japan, he researches every place. How many places have you gone to, separate, like unique places in all our trips to Japan? Oh,
like
that's a
hundreds.
Number. That's a Hilo number, you know. Oh, when
so
you
many.
Ask somebody how many, oh, so many.
So plenty. No, but then he'll go like three different places in the same night just to try, just to make sure that he gets
them all
there. Yeah, compare.
And he likes the super spicy ones too.
Yeah, the like cry kind.
We went to LA.
Yeah, in Japantown in LA. Yeah. I remember that.
Yeah, and he tried like
he tried the one that makes everybody cry.
Yeah, and he cried. Yeah. Oh, he's sweating. Sorry,
his eyes were sweating.
Yeah. Well, how long has Aaron been playing it with?
Aaron has been with us for
over 10 years.
Oh, way longer. Because I was
15.
Yeah, 15.
Oh, way longer.
Maybe?
Sorry.
I don't know.
2003.
Really?
2003.
Oh, did we give you 17? A 15-year award?
No.
Oh, shame on us.
Did you not get your tie clip in the mail?
Did you get the pen?
Yeah. We did give him a gnome at 10 years.
A gnome.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. He probably wanted a raise, but anyway. On bass and guitar. Today, we have Mr. Jack Ofuya, who has been playing with us for forever also.
Yes.
Jack was always the guy that we'd call for fill-in on anything. He's played keyboards for us a few times, too. Wow. Remember Maui? We had to do a couple
gigs. He's played
drums,
and I think once he played drums while he played the keyboard.
Yeah, he was sitting on the drum.
And he was, like, playing, like...
Up at Partners in Makawao.
Yes.
Remember that?
Mr. Bojangles.
Amazing.
We love Jackis.
Yes, thank you. Thanks for joining us. But, we're going to take it back a little bit again and do a song that you guys recorded. I believe Ken wrote this song.
He
wrote this song, and it seems like to have that oldies sort of feel to it.
Yeah, it does.
Do you know
it's that four chord kind of thing.
Yeah,
well, you know, it's funny. I fell in love with this song when I was living on Maui, and I used to go listen to another group play this song. All the time I see them at this one restaurant, and I love this song, and so I didn't know that Ken had written it.
What was the group?
Oh, shucks, I forget their name.
Seriously, we weren't the first ones to sing this?
No, they never recorded it though, but they sang it. Yeah.
So Ken didn't write it for you guys.
All these years, I'm just deflated.
Oh no, that's just age. I'm just kidding. sorry. Back to my story. Merv Owana folks used to play it. I forget the name of his group at the time, but used to watch them play it. And then when I wanted to ask them, you know, if we could record the song. And then they told me that Ken wrote. I was like, what? So Ken was our producer already. I said, what? I love this song. So he said, oh, yeah. He said, there's only two verses. So he goes, go write one third verse. I said, really? He goes, yeah, go write a third verse. So I wrote the third verse. Just,
oh, I didn't know
just
that.
Because we needed to make it a little bit longer. But
hey, I never put you down for the co-composer.
I know. It's okay. I was a little bit incognito. It's all good.
Oh, wrong.
I could be wrong.
Great story.
Well, this is a song that we don't do all the time.
No, we don't.
We've only done this one a couple times.
So. A lot of the old-timers love this song, though.
Yeah, I love this song.
This was on our Friends album, and North Shore. Yeah, Friends, North Shore, and this song.
All right.
On that one.
See if you remember this one.
It's so nice to be with you, though you never linger long. It's so nice to see your smile whenever things just seem so wrong. When I'm near you, all my troubles seem to fade and disappear. And for a while I see my dreams come shining through. It's so nice to make believe. I'd awaken every morning, holding you in my arms. When you're near me, all my days just seem to hurry by so soon. For a while I'd spin the love, sha-la-la-la-la-la-la. Now burn a candle in the night, and hope that soon its flickering light will guide you here to me. Now keep the fire burning strong, hope it won't take too long for you to come to me.
Mr. Aaron Nielsen. Candle in the Night by Mr. Kenneth Mokokane, not written for Naleo.
Distinction. And the third verse by What's Her Name?
The Otter Girl. The Otter Girl. Yeah.
What's Her Name?
Yeah. Once again, thanks for joining us here on Malie Sundays. You can catch us on KSG Films Facebook, on the Shana Lehua Facebook. We also have a whole bunch of people that are cross posting. Awana mahalo, mana maoli, Hawaii Music Live, Aaron and Wade and Randy guys that they're also streaming us live on their website as well as their app, Hawaii Music Live, always supporting live local music here. Oha, I'd like to thank Brother Patrick Landeza up in Kaliponi, Island Style, Lehua Kalima, who is that?
I don't know who's that.
Anyway, Kavaivai, Pomeka Elaiman, we love her. Thank you for cross-posting. And then also Naleo Pilimihana's Facebook, we're cross-posting on there, and you're going to be able to go back and watch it over and over again as much as you want, because we're going to repost this as well, and you can have your own watch parties and stuff like that. And speaking of which, we do have a tip jar that we put up. It's a virtual tip jar. Again, we're all musicians. None of us are working. And so we started doing these a few months ago just to kind of like more so, you know, spread aloha and bring the aloha into your guys' homes, because things were just so, you know, uncertain. Mm. And I think everyone was really uneasy. And so we thought by playing music, it would kind of make it feel like it's, you know, everything's kind of normal, even though we can't go out to like the bars and...
Okay, Sean, so I've actually thought of a third thing that this is the first ever for Naleo, because I still want the folks who are watching to come up with the other two.
Sorry, they answered.
They answered?
Yeah, they got them right.
Did people get them right?
Yeah, they did.
Okay.
What was the answer?
Because I got a third one, too.
The first one was first time we ever sat down singing.
Yes.
We always stand up.
Trained singing in concert glee, you would never sit like this.
Especially not in your mamo howl.
Right. Yeah, that's right. We were told never to sit in your mamo.
Sit in your mamo.
Does anybody wear mamo howl anymore?
Yeah, if you're size zero.
I think I made mine into a mask.
I think you did. I saw it.
And you never even have to cut them up. Just
shameful.
Just elastic on them. Yeah.
Just tie the sleeves around your head. And then what was the second thing? That
the only two people, LZ, said we didn't have shoes on. First time we never wear shoes. Because we don't like to get electrocuted usually. So we put shoes on most of the time.
So now you guys know how cute our feet are.
Okay.
Yeah, you guys and she got six toes on one foot. Not just kidding.
Yeah, that's a big...
Hold on.
Long kept secret.
And then you thought of a third thing.
I thought of a third thing. This is the first time Naleo has ever live streamed.
Ooh.
Whoa, what?
The first one. All right.
Oh, now I'm sweating.
It's kind of epic.
Pressure.
Yeah, it is. Well, this is going to be the new norm for a while. And so we thought this is a great idea. Kili'i really wanted you guys on the show. I was like, yeah, I think we know some people that could help this, you know, make it happen.
Only Kili'i. So. You guys didn't want us.
Well, we tried to talk them out of it. And it's just like, I mean, there's like, you know, some other people. And they're going to lift the quarantine, neighbor island kind, like next week. So if we could just hold on, maybe we could bring somebody else.
Yeah,
but I was
right.
Like, well, okay. Well, we're super happy to have you guys. And, yeah, I mean, we'd love to keep doing these and, you know, as long as we can. And just keep the music going, you know, and keep doing live streams. Because nobody watches TV anymore. There's, like, no new stuff on TV.
I don't watch it. So junk.
It's depressing.
Like, yeah. I've been watching all the 90-day 90-day fiancé thingies.
Oh, gosh.
We love that show.
Yeah, and some of them are really good, and some of them are like, really? Like, they're just getting catfished. They should be on Catfish, not on that show. But
yeah.
What shows have you guys been watching on TV?
Like, I just watch HGTV.
I don't want to admit, because I think I watch like serial reality shows, and some of them are terrible.
Oh, yeah. Like, do you binge watch them, though?
Yeah, for sure, if I can.
Oh, yeah. I did a few of those.
Married at First Sight, I like that one.
Did we watch that one?
Mm-hmm.
I don't really watch that one, yeah. What about you, Ange?
We watch a lot of Blue Bloods and Chicago PD, ER, and Fire. And then we also watch on Thursdays. You guys got to watch it. It's super fun. On Thursdays, I think at 7 o'clock, is Celebrity Watch Party.
Oh, yeah,
where
that's
celebrities
funny.
Watch.
Yeah,
I
yeah.
did see
we
that.
Did watch
I saw
fun.
That this past day, yeah.
Yeah.
And they're just like, they're talking about like whatever they're watching.
It's hard to follow, though, because you don't know. Like, they jump from like station to station or like show to show.
Yeah, it's fun, though.
Yeah.
The Voice this year was good.
Yeah.
The
Voice.
Oh, because the boy was on.
The
boy. Oh, he's our boy.
Thunderstorm.
Yeah, Thunderstorm. Well, I think we should have a hula because it's been a while since we've had a hula. So
All
I'm going to ask Pona to come and join us on this next song.
This is another song that Ken wrote.
It is. This is like the Ken segment.
This is the back to back.
The back to back. In fact, speaking of Ken, he still plays at the Pandanus Club. They did a live stream yesterday with Roddy Lopez and Alden Levi. And Jack played with them too yesterday too. Yeah.
Wow. Jack, he's a man. He's a jack of all trades.
So they had literally. They had all the uncles yesterday. All the uncles was there.
All the uncles.
And actually, I played on this album when you guys recorded this. Ken brought me in to play on this record. Was this Pocket Full of Paradise?
No, album? Was the title song.
Yeah. But it was the name of the album?
This song.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, okay. But that song was...
the album before Pocket Full of Paradise.
Oh, okay. Because I remember playing on this one too. But, so this goes back a little while, yeah. But this is a song that we send this one out. Who do you guys want to send this one out to?
To all of our friends like on the mainland, in Japan, in foreign countries who can't get here and are observing all of the rules to not come here and and you know keep the COVID population down. We appreciate you folks, you know, following the rules and trying to make this place a safer and better place for all of us. So mahalo to all of you folks.
Yeah, and because I'm in the hospitality, the hotel industry, I really want to mahalo all of our tourists who are eager to come back to Hawaii and spend their vacation time with us, but they are respecting those rules and stuff. We want you back. As soon as all of this is taken care of and we all malama each other and we take care of our family and friends and ourselves and we respect all of the, you know, the protocols and stuff, we can all get back to enjoying life.
Right.
Every time I listen to my heart telling me he longs to go back home, and it makes me want to, 'cause I miss you.
Beautiful. Thank you. That's one of my favorites. Okay. So now we're going to move over to Lehua.
Yes.
And we're going to ask her, tell us something about us that you really like.
Oh, and that's our show for today.
No, let's see.
I am all ears.
Let's see. Let's talk about, I know, what's the favorite song that you like that each one of them sings or has recorded or done live? Yeah.
Okay, let's see.
And why?
Well, you know, we do these disco parties, or we used to a
while
back.
We still do.
Yeah, once in a while. But I like those because we have a lot of fun doing those ones. And Angie actually has a few that she sings that I like when we do those parties because she give them, huh? She just give them. But
Which one?
She gives all. No, but there's that one. The Lady Gaga one. I like that one. That when you do that one, which one is that?
Lady Gaga.
Yeah, was it Lady Gaga or was it another? There's some chick.
That's not disco.
One. Most recently, I like that other one, the Spanishy one. Was it Shakira?
Oh no.
Yeah.
That one.
Yeah. So sexy.
My heart is in Havana, ooh, na-na.
I like that
he
one.
He took me back to, he said, Atlanta, na-na-na. I know my heart is in Atlanta, not Havana.
Or Kahala, maybe.
Eating bananas.
And then Nalani, I mean, that's so, like, I'm sorry if that's boring, but I like those, so.
No, those are
too
fun.
Bad.
I like
question.
When you do that. I like when you do the disco stuff and then Angie dances.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And you guys like talk about like the dance, like.
Because she always could dance, like, and so she shows the moves like the rag doll. Yeah. She shows the evolution of music actually.
I'm waiting.
So you want me to get up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Since this is the first gig that you guys have ever.
Oh my.
And this is the thing, right? Something about whatever dance you're doing.
Oh yeah, whatever dance that you do is the same dance that you did your senior year of high school, because that's the last one that you ever did. So that's the one you stick with for the rest of your life. So Angie likes to explain that, you know, every dance starts with just the two step, like this, step, step, step.
Is that the bon dance?
And then in the 80s, we added a little dip to it. Oh, sexy. Watch out. And then a double dip. Watch out. It's coming.
That was three.
Twice.
I counted three. Sometimes we do two and
aftershock.
It's
an aftershock.
The tremors, huh?
That's how you pop.
And then there's that. Oh.
That's new.
Tremor.
We never saw that one before. That's a new one.
That's a good one.
Whoa.
Yeah. And then she's getting. Oh yeah, give her tips. Make it rain, baby.
Are all the cameras on?
Make it rain.
We need to do more disco parties.
Oh, I saw. Yes. We just got $3 in Venmo. Awesome.
All in quarters.
$30 bills.
Yeah. So 25 cents every 15 minutes. Whoa. Whoa. Hey.
She has to end it.
Now we're minusing.
Now we got to pay people.
Now we're negative. We owe Venmo money.
Okay, wait. I want to hear what Lehua likes about me.
What I like about Nalani? What is my favorite song you sing?
Oh, just anything you like about me. It doesn't have to be a song.
Oh, what I like about Nalani?
Awkward silence.
Do we need to go to a commercial?
No, Nalani has always been the backbone of our group. I mean, she's always like stuck up for us. in any situation, had always had our best interests at heart.
That's so sweet.
No, for sure. Like, I knew that's why we made her the business manager, other than the fact that me and Angie don't like to do business. she knew what she wanted. She always, you know, let us know what was going on.
You know, to the point where when it back in the early 90s, she basically told us, you know what, I'm going to take a, what is it, sabbatical or whatever you call it, from her job, and I'm going to just solely work on Naleo because, you know, we can make this work. We went, okay, two of us put in our notice. And Nalani's like, wait, what? No, I am going to take time off, not the two of you. And we're like, no, but we're all in this together, right? Right? And when you work for the state and the
federal government,
so we took gave our 2 weeks notice and we were out.
She had a pressure to make sure that we could actually survive after that, but she made it work.
What year was that?
That was in
96.
Yeah, 96. No, I moved back in 95, so.
It was in 96.
No. Was it? Oh, okay. Wow. Maybe I moved back early before I quit my job.
I think you guys like always remember what year it was by like what kid you had.
I didn't have any, so.
Yeah.
Those are a blur. And then the years after you have a kid is like totally a blur because it's like, what? I don't remember anything after 2000.
It was the year that we signed with Sony Records.
Oh, okay.
And I was still working at the bank and Flying with Angels had won the Hokus that year.
Ah, nice.
That's why I remember.
Well, let's take it back a bit. And since you guys have been friends, and we did this really cool graduation video. For all the graduates. Congratulations to all the 2020 graduates again. I think they actually have like the most awesome graduation
this year. People went out.
I don't know how they're going to top that next year. I feel bad for the parents for next year that you guys have kids graduating because they're going to want all the virtual stuff and then all the real stuff too.
But that's right.
Yeah. But you guys were kind of the middle part of this music video that we had put together. And I think when you guys came on, and it was so unexpected, when you guys started singing all together, everybody was like, ooh! And then they all started crying. Ooh!
No, it was when you started singing, Sean, then it was just crying.
Yeah, it was like right after that. Yeah, exactly.
I kid.
Yeah. But it was such an awesome moment, and thank you for sharing this song. So I think we're going to take it back and do something for all the friends that you guys... And you guys did this for... like graduations before, but then you were asked not to do this song for a certain reason.
Well, it was the class of 94.
And
there was just some brew up, and you know, because the word has God and Lord in it, you know, we can't. It's the difference between church and state, and public schools were said they cannot. But you know, like Nalani says, you tell a child not to touch the stove, they're going to touch the stove. So you tell them not to sing this song, they're going to sing it anyway.
Right. And I think more so than anything, we need this song, you know, in our lives and this message. Yeah. So, let's do this one for all our friends.
Shoots.
Springing from the hope we know.
2020 graduates, congratulations. It's the classic. You know, we always, like, when I'm doing gigs with Lei Huo, they always ask, like, can you guys do friends? I go, no, because we need the other two friends.
I know. And I said, no, and I only sing the harmony, so I honestly don't even know what I'm supposed
to. And you know what's funny? Was it, there was a funeral recently. Was it President Bush?
Oh, no, yeah.
Senior.
Oh, no, no. It was,
Yeah. No.
No, the other guy. Sorry, that's not. I know who you mean.
That's not the funny part. The funeral.
No.
But
yeah. No. No.
They were playing Friends at the funeral.
Oh, no, I think you're right.
National
it was.
Funeral.
It
I think it was George Bush Senior.
Yeah. That's
and
right.
They played the original version of Friends.
Michael W. Smith played it.
Michael W. Smith played it, and then everybody was calling, saying, "Hey, Naleo, they're playing your song."
And they were like, "Well, actually, it's his song."
Yeah.
But thanks.
That's funny. Thank you. Well, once again, we want to thank you guys. Thanks to Naleo for coming on and sharing this Maliye Sunday with us. We've
Thanks
been waiting for this. Yeah.
Yeah,
we wanted to be like super, super special. And we thought, well, this weekend would be really, really nice to have you guys. We love shooting over here at Kauai Vice. I want to thank Mahina and the staff here. Once again, for those of you that don't know where we are, we're at Kauai Vice Collective, which is in Mo'ili'ili. And Kauai Vice Collective, I'll just give you a little history real quick. It was founded by a group of Native Hawaiian entrepreneurs that share kuleana and a passion for uplifting the lahui through collective values. And so if you guys want to come over here and you can join here and you guys can have your meetings, a lot of creative things that happen over here. They do lots of community events. They do awa and ai, they do lomi lomi stuff. They do all kinds of crafting things and practitioners that come and share their ike with you. So please come and support them. You can go on vaivaicollective.com and sign up for some of these things. They also have a Facebook and Instagram, so please support them because they support our lahue and our community as well. So mahalo again to Kauai Vai for having us.
Yeah. And I just want to say, too, also thank you to Young's Fish Market and
yes.
Jackie Buder of Barefoot Leaf for the Ono Grinds. They dropped off some bentos for us.
Yes.
Mahalo, Jackie.
Yes,
appreciate it so much.
Please go and support all the local restaurants and vendors that are open. You know, things are opening slowly, so please go out and support them because a lot, you know, we're hearing like Hazard is closing down,
yeah.
And a bunch of some of our favorite restaurants
Real
that we like to go to. Yeah, Real
Gastro
Pub. And so please go and support them. And if you can, give a little bit here and there. I want to thank Kili'i Grace, our director as well, KSG Films. Again, we're doing this all on volunteers. Everybody here is a volunteer. We're all doing this for free. Jason Taglinetti of HPR, Hawaii Public Radio. Go and support him as well. He has a site called Applause in a Small Room, I'm sorry. Applause in a Small Room. He has a Facebook page and whatnot, and they're still doing lots of cool stuff from there. He's also doing stuff from Blue Note. Really, really cool things. Brother Lono Nevalu, who's been a sound tech for so many years. A lot of entrepreneurs and independent contractors and gig workers like us that are, everybody's out of work. So if you feel tipsy, if you feel like donating, yeah, please, our Venmo and PayPal and Cash App is up there as well. And we share it with everybody who's volunteering to put this together. We don't have any other, really any sponsors. We co-collaborate with Kauai Vai for this space. So we appreciate that. Yes, again, thanks to everybody who's cross-posting, everyone who's shared online as well, some of your thoughts and stuff. But once again, I want to introduce the band again, Mr. Aaron Nelson from Hilo, Brother Jack Ofoya from Pearl City. Yeah, you can watch them. They're great musicians in their own right as well. And again, all the way on my far left, the lovely Angela Morales. Thank you so much. In the middle, Miss Nalani Jenkins. Thank you, thank you. And what's your name again?
Say something nice about me. Come on.
Yeah, so anyway, we're going to just the lovely Lehua Kalima Alvarez.
Thank you.
Thank you guys for being here.
It's fun because
we haven't played music together in a while. You know, we're supposed to do like a Japan tour, and then that fell through. I think the last time we went to Japan, and then we got stuck there because the huge typhoon.
They got
Yes.
So I think a one-week trip turned into like a three-week trip.
So much fun.
And some of us had to come back through San Francisco to get home.
Yes.
But yeah, lots of good memories. I think that one will be your next one, Ange, next time we talk about like terrible trips.
Sure.
So, yeah. But more music to come from Naleo. Anything new coming out? Anything that we should watch for?
We're just gonna know.
Yeah.
No, keep you guessing.
Yeah. Always writing, always new things coming out. Hopefully some new gigs. I know you guys have some stuff on the calendars that hopefully happen in the next. On the day. It's on the day.
We're still living and breathing, so I think we can still be making music.
That's good.
Well, it's healing to everybody, so thank you. Thank you to everybody for coming and sharing that.
Thank you.
We also want to let you know we do have a very special Father's Day that we're doing next week for Amalie Sundays here.
Yay.
We're teaming up with Kawaii Vai, and they're teaming up with a restaurant nearby called The Nook. And so we're going to have a very special Father's Day where you can buy into. I think it's like a VIP thing that Mahina and Kovaiva are coming up with, along with The Nook. And so look for that. Go on Kovaiva Collective. I'm sorry, VaiVaiCollective.com. And follow them on Instagram and Facebook, as well as us on KSG Films and the Shauna Lehua page, because we'll be giving you details on what's to come for next week as well. So, which would be awesome, because it's nice. We have a few friends that had come in today and joined us. The lovely Tracy and our sister over there, Kau'i. She's a kumuhula as well. So it's always nice to see you folks. And our other friends, Ricky and sister. Sister that Jack brought in some friends as well. So mahalo to them for coming in. And sister, tira. Yeah, tira. Yeah.
Sean, I have one quick one.
Yeah.
Naleo's trying to get up to 1,000 YouTube subscribers. So for those of you who are out there, if you want to hear more Naleo music, find us on YouTube. We have our own YouTube channel. And please just click that red subscribe button because we're getting close.
Ooh, is it just under Naleo or is it Naleo Pilimihana?
Naleo Pilimihana.
Okay, awesome. Yeah, look up that. Because I know you post a lot of the videos and the concerts that we've done. Like some of the stuff that we had posted before this week was footage that was shot in Japan at Billboard Live and those sorts of things and some fun concerts that we've done in the past. So again, thanks to Kili Grace for doing that. But we're going to take it back to the very, very beginning,
yeah,
I think.
This is the one.
Yeah, this is the one. So
so we're ending with the very first Naleo song. Is that it?
Yep.
Yeah.
Why not? All right.
We'll bookend it.
Set it up for us, Lehua. What was the year?
It was 1984.
Angie, what was the month?
April.
February.
Close.
It was February.
I'll split the difference and say March. But
no, it was February because it was right before my birthday.
Okay. So what was the year?
84.
What was the month?
February.
And what was the song?
Local Boys.
Blue eyes and blonde, it don't thrill me. 'Cause I'm in love with the local boys. Don't try to convince me. Because the local boys are no ka'oi. Doesn't matter what island, in the mountains or near the sea, if I want someone special, the local boys are the one for me. You may say I'm crazy, but I'm right. The local boys will keep you warm throughout the coldest nights, wherever you go in the island. The Malahini on the street, but my eyes never wander. Because the local boys can't be beat. Oh, oh, local boys. La da 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 da. Local boys. You may say I'm crazy, but I'm right. Local boys Local boys will keep you warm throughout the coldest night. Blue eyes and blonde hair don't thrill me.
Bringing it on home.
'Cause I'm in love with the local boys. Don't try to convince me. Because the local boys are no good. I said I love those local boys.
Once again, mahalo for joining us here on Malie Sundays. On behalf of ourselves and Naleo Pilimehana, take care of each other. Aloha aina. See you guys soon. Aloha.
Aloha. Aloha.